Hello and welcome to game between Jon Snow and Juan on Arena. We have Jon Snow in green playing as the Celts and we have Juan in purple playing as the Koreans here. I have a special reason to show you this match. I've seen it before, so I'm mainly gonna know what's going to happen, and I'm gonna show you that sometimes it can be beautiful. It's some clip of the day scenes that I'm hope to catch, to find here. And let's go for the maps either way. Let's start with Juan here in this case. Main gold and main stone to the front here, not too far away. He wants to get a castle up, and he's gonna get it up. Second gold stone outside and to the front here. He got four deer inside, he got a second gold inside, here's an extra gold. Third gold on the right hand side, good for him as well. And it's not too far away from his base. So all in all, a good map I think, except for the main resources here. That's why he wants to get stone very early. Let's go for the relics. We have one, two in between them, three and four, a little bit closer to Juan, this one closer to Jon Snow. And let's go for Jon Snow's base then. Jon Snow main gold on the side, close to the second stone here, might wall it off, not sure if he's doing so. Second gold is outside, main stone is also to the front here. He got two deer, three deer inside maybe, I'm not too sure, there's one outside. I think he's got those two deer in. And he's getting the third one, this is one of his sheep, very good. On the other hand, on the other side of this map, we have in the back third gold here, extra berries and an extra gold as well. Well, good for him. All in all, I think pretty fair maps here. Nothing too special that's happening. And we're gonna see Jon Snow going for a gold already. 24 villages is gonna be up a little bit earlier as far as I know. At the same time, Juan is going for gold, but he wants to go for stone soon as well. I think he's gonna go with two villages on stone before clicking up, maybe three. Yeah, on this point he has to go with three villages on gold. Stop all tapping, I guess it's a little bit laggy maybe. Juan got six villages on the berries here. Two lumber camps and each four villagers. Celts, of course, don't need more on wood because they're collecting wood really fast, and that's why we see 7, 8, 9 farms already. Because you can just afford it here. Juan up to feudal age as well, and Jon Snow just up to castle age. I guess he had a little bit too much wood and didn't seed farms in time, but he's still ahead, of course. And Juan should have the stone to get a castle here very soon. He is in stone with only three villagers. I'm not sure why. Maybe he's buying stone here. Not happening at this point. He's sending more right now. Maybe he wants to go for monastery first. It's lacking sometimes. Yeah, and they are a little bit of a laggy game here. I think it's getting better later on. Both players are scouting around. Nothing too special happening. And I think, except for a little bit of fighting for the relics, there won't happen too much in early castle age. Siege workshop coming up immediately. And the monastery coming up here. Waiting for a little bit more stone. He got 650 now. Going for the castle here. A good position. Protecting both main gold and main stone. And a mangonel already coming up, of course, for Koreans, plus one range is good. And both scouts are out still, both are injured, but now Jon Snow healing a scout is gonna go out right now. And he's gonna try and find a scout or maybe the monk here. Castle is up, but the relic is out of range, and as Jon Snow is losing the monk here, he almost killed the scout from Jon Snow, and Jon Snow got the first relic in as far as I can see. Juan is now moving out the mangonel and two monks here. Should go and get these two. See, the scout is still out for Jon Snow. He might snipe one. He's going for a mangonel, going back. Jon Snow losing a monk here. And mangonel shot on the monk, both dying. Good job from Juan here at this point. There's a lot of villagers in stone right now, and gold right now. You got three TCs up and running as far as I can see. Jon Snow got one, two, three TCs. He went for the extra berries. Good job from him. And Siege Workshop won mangonel in. Both players right now booming as far as I can see. Not too much happening. Mangonel and Warwagon on the last relic here. The other relics are in. I think Jon Snow got two relics in the monastery here. No, only one. And Juan must have four. Four relics would be a lot. Yep, there we go. He got three, and he's gonna get the last one as well. There we go. Otherwise, not too much happening here. Juan a little bit behind in resources, maybe, because Jon Snow clicking up to Imperial Age at this point. Walling up a little bit, just in case, I guess. And getting double barracks up, we're gonna see pikemen from him. Battering rams being queued up. He's going for the castle, he's gonna do a ram push here, but probably in Imperial Age, not in Castle Age, because he's up soon. At the same time, Juan going for a forward castle here. Mangonel hitting one monk, hitting the war wagon can take it. And Mangonel also in for Juan. Now the castle will go up. That's three rams against the Mangonel. It's not enough here. Imperial Age is done for Jon Snow almost. Juan just clicking up. He's basically 2 minutes behind, I guess. Yeah, pretty much. And pikeman coming in. Halberdier should come in any time after that. Or is Jon Snow going for maybe Capram's first? Yep, Capram coming in. So missing a little bit of food right now. While Siege Workshop forward coming up and an outpost for Juan here. Juan halfway to Imperial Age at this point. He's on 1, 2, 3, 4 TCs now. Jon Snow should be on 4 as well. I'm not sure. Did he get a number 4? No, not yet. And same amount of villagers though. That's not too much of a difference here. Now 4, 5, 6, 7 Capdrams and the pikemen coming out. It's even 8, so this castle is going to fall. The mangonels and villagers are already going back. Pikemen and the halberdier is done and gonna hit the mangonel here. Imperial Age almost done for Han, but he's gonna lose the... actually converting a halberdier, good job from him. But losing the war wagon, losing the castle, losing the fort basically. And Siege Ram already being researched to Jon Snow while Juan going for Onager. Now this castle will go down as well, I think. As far as I remember, Halberdier going into the Capdrams, maybe? Yeah, there we go. This one a little bit faster now. Juan already walling up behind this. Onager is done, so, but also Siege Ram. And Siege Ram's moving in on the castle, on the walls here. Nice Onager shots from Juan here. Managing to keep the walls alive and walling behind us with gates. Look at this, that's three gates here. And three onagers will do the job. Jon Snow can't go in right now. He's not cleared the barracks here. He's getting more halberdiers at this point. While, what is Juan doing? Let's see, Juan. A lot of resources. He's going for Siege Onager soon, it seems. He needs 750 gold, or 600, I think 750 and 1450 food. He's housed on 100 because he lost the two castles, needs to get a few more houses, but he can't click Siege Onager right now. And he's doing so. Yeah, Siege Onager coming in. Very good for Koreans, of course. Gonna have plus one range compared to the Siege Onagers from Jon Snow. Jon Snow at this point not even going for Onager as far as I can see. So we're gonna see. Siege Onager will be able to defend, maybe even push here, but no other military for now for Juan. He's going archer ranges now. Gonna see either hand cannoneers or elite skirmishers. Both work against the halberdier. Of course, hand cannoneers cost gold again, while the elite skirmishers only trash units basically. So let's see what he's going to do. Not sure about it actually. Chemistry coming in to make the siege archers even stronger. Few siege rams moving out. Outpost here, but I think it might go down as it started to get up. One siege ram is lost. Halberdiers moving in to attack the villager and nothing else. Not too sure about this, but as long as the siege onagers are behind the walls, Jon Snow won't be able to go in too easy. Onagers coming in for Jon Snow. No siege engineers being done for Juan. Not sure what these walls are about. Don't really matter. Castle coming up from Jon Snow here. And right now, Jon Snow looking better with a little bit of map control, but Juan in the score lead. And the siege onagers, of course, plus two range now. Not sure if that was the... No, why they have plus two range? Is it Imperial Age or is it Siege Onagers that get the plus two? Is it Siege Engineers? I'm not too sure about it. 10 range compared to... Do we have Onagers from Jon Snow somewhere? I don't see any. He did the Onager upgrade, but he's not doing any more Onagers right now. Juan with a huge amount of gold, 2k6 already. Resources also looking good for Jon Snow. He doesn't know what to do apparently, because he could click Siege and he could click Heavy Scorpions, which wouldn't make sense. Elite Vote Raider coming in now. Yeah, and Onagers hitting the siege rams. Siege Onagers are not a problem for him here. Now he's moving for the Siege Onagers on 8+2 against the 8 range from the castle. Hand cannoneers coming out here, killing the halberdier. Now that's good for Juan here, because he can hit the castle without being hit. Not even fletching coming in. Nice shots on the halberdiers and the siege generals. Of course, we have 7, 8 siege generals at 7, and the halberdiers will go down very fast, I think. Hit from the onager here. One going down, two going down. Good job, killing two with two onagers, and halberdiers killing another one. One losing 4 onager, siege onagers here, but all in all, not really worth it, I guess. Or maybe, I'm not sure. Siege workshop, another siege workshop coming up for Juan here. 127 villagers for Juan, compared to 112 from Jon Snow. So let's see, elite vote rate is being queued up here. Not going for siege archer yet, but he should do so soon. Resources looking very good for Jon Snow to do so. Get it up, sorry. Resources even looking better for Juan, who is still only 160 because he's housed, getting a castle now, killing a few halberdiers here, making sure he can take the gold safely. And two men saw ring archer armor. Siege archer finally coming in for Jon Snow too. Juan doesn't even know what to do with his resources. Oh my god. So bad pronunciation for me. Doesn't matter. Hand cannoneers and siege archers. Let's see. This could be interesting. I think Jon Snow is waiting for a siege runner to come. Halberdiers are moving in, and look at this. Boom! All the halberdiers down. Nice shot from the siege runners. Very, very nice. That's flattening. Shinky Chon now coming in for Juan, making the siege on it just even stronger as far as I know. Does it get more range? I think it's 11 range then. Don't really remember, but it should happen anytime soon. Yep, there we go. Plus 3 range on those siege on just. That's a huge advantage. Look at this range. So far away from the castle and still can hit it. Could get it down with the siege on just alone. Siege Launcher also coming in for Jon Snow, is gonna have it right now. And let's see, attack round on the Wood Raiders. Hitting two with one Siege Launcher, another one is down. And still that's like 10-11 from Juan. But now, first hit, hitting like, well, what is that, 3 or 4? Maybe 5 even down, and another hit. Killing 4 more siege on it. Look at this. What a great success for Jon Snow here. What a great, two great shots here. He's losing 3, I think, but he's killing like 10 or 11 siege on it just for this. Very good for him. Very strong performance here. A little bit of bad luck maybe for Juan, but he should have split his siege challenges. Last one is down for the castle. Now traps are coming out and more siege challenges being created. Juan still with a lot of resources. Castle coming up for Jon Snow forward. He's not gone for the Furo Celtica upgrade yet, so the siege is still on 70 HP, Ram still on 290. Is it 290? 270? I think it's 270. No fletching done either. A few elite vote raiders full upgraded coming in. Furo Celtica being researched right now, but good siege onager shots here, and the hand cannoneers will take care of the elite vote raiders. One siege onager down, but the others should be fine now. This siege workshop might fall, otherwise not too much happening here. Both players still gathering resources. Not too much aggression coming up. More siege workshops being built by Jon Snow. I'm gonna go fast again. And I'm waiting for the next good onager shots before this game is gonna end sooner or later. Not sure how it ended actually, or why it ended. Let's see what's going to happen. Chemistry coming for Jon Snow as well as fletching to give the castles more range, I guess. And a few lead vote raiders on the trap here. This trap is not going down actually. Hand cannoneers there, but only on 16 HP. Two traps hitting the castle. Jon Snow is repairing it. A few more elite vote raiders coming in. Juan now deleting the walls. And can he get a few attack run shots? Yeah, not too bad here. Elite vote raiders 80 HP. That's pretty good. The traps are down because siege oranges from Jon Snow hitting them. And siege on now with 105 HP. I think Juan killing his own here, not too good. The lead warder is gonna take care of the rest. Might going for the traps. Wow, two vote raiders, two lead warders killing the trap, although they're in castle in range of the castle fire. And architecture now coming in from Jon Snow as well as long swordsman. Is he gonna go for champions? Probably. Nice shot from him. Getting another one maybe. Yeah, pretty much even Steven here with the siege onager shots. Juan now going forward again, but Jon Snow going back. He still manages to have the castle here. Now siege onager on the left hand side, and Jon Snow is gonna cut in like it's Black Forest style. Let's see if he's gonna be able to do so actually. Siege onager out for Juan, not losing it. Can he get a shot? Yep, there you go, but the HP for Jon Snow, huge advantage. And right now the elite voters are going into the wood line. If they could for wood on this tree left, now it's open and Jon Snow should go in all the elite voters that he has. He's sending them, but he doesn't have too many of them right now. 200 swordsmen being researched by Juan, and a few siege archers on the left hand side. While these traps are going down, I'm not sure, did he Jon Snow shoot on the castles maybe? The siege rams are going down, the siege archers just too strong, very good shots here, and the hand cannoneers are going to do the rest. Wow, flattening again. At the same time, siege archers moving forward, 200 swordsmen against the siege archers and elite vote raiders. Right hand side, one was left, but going down. And let's see how Jon Snow going to do. Can he get a good shot here? One shot killing, like, look at this. He's losing three, but one shot killing six siege archers at the same time. Elite vote raiders running in on the wood line. I guess that's why Juan didn't manage to kill the last siege archer here. Was busy on the left hand side. A lot of forest cut down. Maybe Jon Snow should even cut in here to make sure he can go in more. Lead orders in the eco from Juan here. The hand cannon is patrolling a few idle villagers. And otherwise, not too much happening because right now Juan is just dealing with the lead orders. Walling this again. See, Siege Onager and Siege Onager. Yeah, both down. And the house is up, so Juan will be fine. I think Juan is not using his full potential. He should get Bombard Towers, maybe. That would be a good help in the defensive part, because right now Elite Warrior is moving in again on the wood line. Jon Snow, Juan has to go back with the villagers. He's still in 134, but he's losing a few here, and he shouldn't lose too many. Siege Rams moving in on the castle, but the Siege Onager is coming in already. Good shots here. 405 HP, it takes so long to kill Siege Rams here. Two are down, and now the last one is down. Castle is standing. No more raiding coming in. Hand Cannon is taking, and Siege Rams are taking care of the Siege Rams and Elite Vote Raiders that are coming in. Talking so fast that it doesn't sound right. Jon Snow taking the stone on the right hand side. Few traps hitting the castle here, good job. Few Siege Onager shots, that's two for nothing. See, those two are going down. Jon Snow losing two, three as well. And again, pretty even, maybe a little bit better for Juan even. Nice micro here. Jon Snow killing the Siege Onager, destroying it, but killing two elite voters at the same time. Not planned here. Jon Snow, 2k food, 1k 5 food, 1k 5 wood here. And look at this one with a lot of resources here. He doesn't really know what to do, what military to get. He's moved on the right hand side, he's repairing the castle. Elite Voter is moving in again. Not sure why, it shouldn't happen. But he doesn't really care at this point, because look at this. 7, 8k wood, 2k food, 2k 6 gold. And still going for more siege onagers and hand cannoneers. Nice army composition, I feel. Not easy to stop, Korean Deathball, but there are no war wagons, there are no halberdier out, because I guess you got enough resources to get the gold units here. And it's not one of the fastest games that I've ever seen, because there's a few pushes, but it's really hard to go into the Koreans' defense with those siege archers with 11 range. It's just so difficult. Now, another approach from Jon Snow is going scouts. Lightcalf is done. Might even go for Hussar if he wants to. Bodkin Arrow is coming in. Lightcalf upgrade is done already. Plus 4 attack, plus 4 defense. Those are fully upgraded except for the Hussar upgrade. I think Celts do get Hussars. They're not too strong, but they get them. Siege rams and traps now. Few siege onager shots here, killing a few of the lead voters. The rams will go down pretty fast. Fortified wall is done for Juan here, and he has fixed the holes. Good for him. Now, ram is going down, the light calf are moving out of the way just in time. The siege onagers might even hit the traps here from inside of the base, opening up right now. Good shot, another one. There is one trap down, and now the light calf are in. Light calf could do a good amount of damage on the siege onagers, but good shot from Juan again. More light calf and more lead vote raiders coming in. Hussar is being researched. Nice shot again, and now this could be an important opportunity for Jon Snow. Hussar is done, but wow, look at this, losing so many just to the shots here, and just like that, all the Hussars died to the siege onager shots. Hand Cannon is doing the rest. Really good from Juan here. I feel Jon Snow losing too many units because they're too crumbled up. Not much space to fight here, and a lot of buildings 4-1, just in the way, basically. Once again, a little bit of raiding coming in from Jon Snow. Hussars moving into the TC, maybe on the farms, maybe on the woodline. But once Eco is so spread out that he can afford it, he still has 133 villagers, and the siege onagers, of course, defending here. A siege ram could move in and kill a few siege onagers. Good position from him, but wow, look at this. And siege on the traps, losing 3 traps. One saying yes here because he hit the rams. He hit the traps, and now the ram is down as well. So the stables are falling for Jon Snow. He's getting more archer ranges up now, probably going for, not sure, lead skirmisher then? Yeah. But against siege onagers, lead skirmish is really not good. A few hussars in on the woodline from Juan here, but he has still 120 villagers. He is fine, and he's still got so many resources, he can really afford it. 195, he should get more houses, I feel. And right now he's not taking care, he's sending a few halberdiers now, lead skirmishers being done. And once again, Jon Snow trying to go in, but this hand cannon and siege onagers doing the job. 1 hour game already. And now, Juan maybe moving in on the right hand side. Not too good to the siege onager there, should be fine. Nobody taking really map control. This Jon Snow maybe a little bit more, but there is this this battlefield basically where nobody's building, where nobody can gain the ground here. And there's not too much happening. Finally, the hussars are being killed by the halberdiers and maybe the TC fire. 110 villages still for Juan, that's fine for him. Halberdiers now in the mix, and bombard cannons actually with 13 range, hitting the castle maybe. Hussars moving in, good shot on the hussars. Hussars on one siege onager, hussars on more siege onagers. Hand cannoneers though, good against the hussars of course, and the halberdiers are taking care of the rest of them. Elite skirmishers against the hand cannoneers, that should be a good fight for Jon Snow, but Juan already moving back. Even killing the woodline here just to have more space, I guess. Siege onagers now hitting the castle again, halberdiers defending from the hussar raidings and making sure the siege onagers don't go down too fast. And Jon Snow at this point calling a GG because he knows, damn, I didn't manage to go in, and this game could take a little bit longer. Look at the resources, still looking good except for gold, and that's one reason, it's the relics here. But the siege onagers from Koreans just not to beat here. I think Jon Snow could have done it maybe, I'm not too sure how. There must have been ways, but Juan taking this game, Jon Snow calling GG is okay. It's, I guess for the players it got even boring because what do you win? Do you win here? You get more and more time lost on this game. And I hope you enjoyed the siege onager shots which were happening on both sides. Really impressive to see how the traps are going down, the halberdiers, the elite vote raiders, the hussars even. And that's why I brought you this game. I saw it live and I thought, wow, what grand hits, what great hits here. Next games shouldn't be like this. There will be different Garena games, and I hope you enjoyed it nevertheless. See you next games. GG.